back. Is he looking over his shoulder because another one's coming? These look very content to be here. These are not worried like those last ones were. This one has an interesting marking above its eyes. It kind of looks like a butterfly. One of those things you fold the paper to make the marks up. Oh, I know what it looks like. It looks like a swallowtail. So her name is Swallowtail. These two don't look skittish at all. Notice how they splay their front legs so they can reach the ground easily. It's not supposed to snow tonight. So those two deer were completely alone. They did empty one bull. Well, I think he saw the bit of white on my wrist. So this is what I look like. I have on my black gloves, dark shirt, and I even took off my glasses. Okay, so they're gone. They're back. These are my four. These four are very comfortable. And they're all yearlings. I assume these are all female, but they might not be. This one has a crown. I think he's going to be called Corona. They often, if they sense danger, they remove to the edge of the danger area. You see them put their foot on that other one. Oh, they can smell all those does that have been here.
Obituaries tell the stories of people's lives and often contain information linking them to generations of their family. Though these records are typewritten and easy to read, they can be deceptively challenging to index. What makes them that way? Mostly it's the very things that make information be valuable to family connections. Keep watching and you'll see what I mean. With indexing obituaries, we'll be faced with many types of documents. You'll see obituary newspaper clippings, continuations of those clippings, funeral announcements, estate sales, and notifications of unidentified bodies in the town, which leads to a disclaimer. Newspaper clippings of how people die are sometimes fairly graphic. You might want to consider steering what to put in the text of the local bylaws. So, let's get started with your birth catch. The first thing you want to do is read the entire obituary. Find out what names are going to be included in the document and other information that you'll find. Then, you'll want to index the obituary. If the document is the first image of the obituary, then you need to define it. If it's a continuation of a document, then you're going to index it as an abstract of the data. You'll be doing that so that you can combine the information from the images on the first page of the document, so that all of the records will be attached to the same deceased person in the obituary. As you continue through, you'll finish the indexing in the consent field, then you'll move to the form option. First, you'll index the deceased person, and then you'll be indexing the relatives and non-relatives after that. So, go ahead and type the deceased person's name, and then knowing that you've already done the document, you'll know that Mr. Valiant here is referencing that future child through the document. So you can go ahead and put that in the notes as a listener. And then the sender is now specifically mentioned as male or female, and he is listed as a sister. So going on his is there, so you can use that to infer that the sender is male. Then you'll look for his age, which in this case is in the second paragraph. It's also another reason why it's important to use the entire document. Don't assume anything that's not on the document. If it's in your memory as something that you know that is a county that is really belonging, don't put that in unless it's stated on the document. For this obituary, there is no death date specifically mentioned in the newspaper, but on the index card provided with the obituary is a death date listed as July 24th. Though Mr. Valiant is listed as a protected Valiant residence, it never specifically mentions the city in which he died, so we'll leave that blank.
That patch seems to look like a turtle.
Continue doing that for each
little mark is like a bracket. A bracket over the eye. So his name is Bracket. And Bracket is here all by himself. There's white marks above the eye and the white down the top of the nose. Look like a scorpion, doesn't it? Scorpion Bracket. Well, that's interesting. They emptied two whole bowls. Or three bowls, I guess. Let's see. One, two, three. And that one's still got a bit in it. Well, that was my four yearlings. So Scorpion Bracket is the name of one that I have been able to figure out a name for. Oh, and the other is Corona. Corona and Scorpion Bracket are two of the yearlings, those four that come regularly. It's cool. It's good to be getting to know them. All right, see you later. You can do this at home. Results may differ. They don't look in each other's eyes. She's a big doll. Well, she might be a small doll. But she's certainly bigger than the yearlings. Her name is Beard. And Beard has hoof lines. And this one has a black line between her front legs. She also has hoof lines. Quite the arch. This one truly has a beard. Well, this one has, I guess we'd call it a bib. Okay, so this is bib, and this is beard.